Hi everyone and welcome back to another Mixed Media Tuesday. Today I will create a tag journal. I have been sharing tag journals for a while now. The feedback in these type of videos is amazing. I know that you guys love those journals, and it is probably because the pages are quite small, so you can put together a layout without spending too much time, but you can still be creative and play with your mediums. And I'm going quickly through some of the tag journals that I shared previously. If you haven't seen those videos, check them out on my channel. For creating a tag journal, you obviously need tags. You can grab tags in a bulk if you like. I did use for one of these tag journals this set by Art by Marlene. This is by Studio Light, and it comes with rings so you can bind the tags together. There are ties that you can add a lovely lace look at the bottom of your pages. And it includes lots and lots of tags with three options on the tabs. But if you don't want to buy this kit, you can always have the option to get just tags. Now, for that you can get this booklet. It is really inexpensive. It comes with 21 tags, so you can put together lots and lots of these type of books. And of course, you can bind them together either with a ring at the top or even fibers, ribbons and such. Or even you can bind them together next to each other, like I'm going to do today, by using washi tape or any other tape. Here is an example where you stick the pages together. This way it looks like a book and you have a bigger area to work with. Or you can use rings. You can see here it didn't work at the back of the tags, but you can always change the orientation and even have a double spread, which is quite wide. So anyway, I'm going to put those aside and let's make a brand new one. For my booklet orientation today, I'm going with three pages. And I will bind them next to each other, so this way I will end up having something like a book. For bringing those pages together, you need to use washi tape or any other tape that you have at home. I decided to work with a tape that is very, very thin, so when you stick something on top, it kind of disappears. Washi tape works for that great. And I am making sure that I leave quite a little bit of a gap in between those tags. This is going to allow them for easy movement, and you will be able to open and close your booklet later on easily. And you can see here the gap that I am talking about. This gap should be the thickness of one tag. And you can see now how easily I can open and close it. I can even turn it completely around. Now I'm going to bring in one more page and I'm going to do the exact same thing. And I have a little booklet ready to go, and I'm planning to cover up all the pages from start to finish. I did manage to fit everything in one video, but this is a warning. This video is going to be quite long. So here is my booklet with just the three tags, but it gives me one single page, two double spreads, this one, and again at the back, another single page. And of course, remember, you can make it as big as you want to. I'm keeping it quite small so that I can fit all the pages in just one video. For all the backgrounds on my pages, I will work with collage paper. This is going to give me quite of an easy way to go through all the backgrounds quickly so that I can have more time to spend on my focal points. Another way to go, which is one that I shared in a previous tag journal video, is to go and work on the backgrounds and then at the end just use die cut pieces as your focal points from a booklet. These are just a couple of ways to minimize the time you spend on a page, either by using ready-made focal points or by using ready-made backgrounds. Of course, you can go all the way and create everything from scratch. So I am picking an area from this collage paper that I want to stick on top of my first page here. And for sticking everything down, I'm going to use my matte medium. I'm going to apply a generous amount at the bottom and then place the collage paper on top slowly, and I'm going to also go over it with matte medium again. If you get some wrinkles, it's not a big deal. Really look at it as texture. Mine isn't perfect. It looks perfect, but it certainly isn't. You can leave it aside to dry or just use your heat tool to speed up the drying process, and then I'm going to use my scissors and cut out all the excess paper. Now, once you do that, make a check on the corners. Usually some of them are sticking out. You don't want that. If this is the case, apply a touch of extra matte medium there to keep everything nice and flat. And you can see here I'm just using my favorite tool, which is my fingers. I will repeat the same process for all the collage papers on all my pages, but I'm not going to show it to you every time. It is going to be the exact same technique. And here is how you can speed up the process of putting together a page if you use ready-made focal points. These are booklets that you can pop out images if you want to. They are already cut out for you and they don't have a white border all around, which is a big advantage for me. But on the other hand, having the cutout images already colored for you, they may not work with your backgrounds. This little girl, for example, would work great with my background, but sometimes you have a background that it is exactly the same color as the focal point that you want to place on top. So that's where stamps come into play. I made many tag journals by using just the ready-made booklets. So for today, I decided to play with the stamps from this collection. The designs are really amazing. I love the art of Art by Marlin. I find the designs really unique. And I love the fact that the stamps are quite big, so they make a good focal point. You can see here the lady, for example. Some of the stamps are the exact same size as the die cuts. However, most of them are big. And just by getting one stamp set, you will have lots of focal points, at least four, for creating different pages. Plus, you get the option to color them any way that you like. So for the first page, I'm going to use the girl in the car, and it comes from the Road Trip stamp set. I'm going to color her with my alcohol markers, and for that I'm bringing in my triblends, and I'm going to do a really quick coloring, always making sure that I use colors that are going to contrast against the background that I have. Once everything is colored, I'm going to use my scissors and fuzzy cut the image. I'm cutting exactly where those black lines are without leaving any border. You already know that I don't mind fuzzy cutting. I find it really relaxing. If you don't fuzzy cutting, you can always play with the ready-made die cuts from the booklet, or you can even stamp directly on your background and color it there. I wanted to bring in the orange from the top of the design on her scarf, so you see I'm adding some more shading there. In the close-up photos you will see that the coloring and the shading doesn't look, the blending doesn't look perfect, and that was my goal here, since this way I'm going to kind of bring everything together, the background with the colored image. And now always when I cut out an image, I go around it with a black marker. This is going to disguise any mistakes that I did, and it's going to look as if I did the fuzzy cutting perfectly. Now the way everything comes together, it looks as if I have two suns at the top. So I want to disguise somehow one of them, so that it looks as if it is a part of the background, but not so prominent. That's why I'm going with a stencil, and if you notice, the stencil is the exact same one used for creating the background. So this is a lovely stencil that has a really generic design, one of those geometric ones that work on pretty much any page. I'm going to apply some embossing paste with my spatula, and I'm going to leave that to dry. Now I'm going to do some stamping, and for all the pages throughout the booklet I will be using the same stamp, which is a text stamp here that I'm using with a black archival ink. And for all the pages, if I need a stencil, I'm just going to bring in the same stencil. So you don't really need many supplies to create one booklet. You can repeat the same products again and again. This way it's going to give kind of a coherent look, so everything looks as part of the same project. I'm using a piece of washi tape by All & Create. This is quickly becoming my favorite washi tape, and I have been using it again and again for the last couple of weeks. And I love that this piece reads make, which is perfect for the first page on a tag journal. Now I want to embellish my page a little bit more, so I'm going to bring in the booklet and I'm going to pop out one of the crowns so that I can place it on top. And you can use clouds, you can use hearts, you can use butterflies, so many elements that you can play with. Here you see I decided to go with three hearts in different sizes. And I absolutely love how this came out. For my quote, I decided to go with a sticker that says, "And so the adventure begins," perfect for the first page. And this comes from a booklet full of quotes from a previous release by Art by Marlene. I like to cut out the quote in smaller pieces and then I go around with a white gel pen if it has a black background. If it has a white background, I always go around it with a black fine marker. I'm also going to add some highlights here and there, which is one of my favorite techniques to do. And always remember that when it comes to art journaling, there is no right or wrong. I like to do white highlights here and there because that's my style and that's what makes me happy. You do you. Whatever makes you happy, it's perfect for art journaling. There is no right or wrong. There is no art journal police. Just remember that. I'm just showing you what I do because that may sparkle some inspiration. Just try different techniques again and again, and the more you create, the more you will find your very own personal style. You can see here some close-up photos on the first page that I made for today, and I did go ahead and added white splashes, if you're wondering. I just video edited that out, however, there are white splashes all over the place. For my next page, I will work with a Windy Day stamp set. Again, many big, unique designs to become your focal points. And like I did for the first page, again, I'm going to use a collage paper for my background. Here I'm going for an ocean scene. That's why I'm using a collage paper that has mostly blue colors on top of it. I'm going to cut out a piece and stick it down again, just like I did on the first page with my matte medium. Once everything was dry, I used my scissors to cut out the excess paper again, and you can also use a sanding block if you want to have nice and clean edges. Now this is going to be a two-page spread. For that I will use the fish with the balloon. I will use one of the boats included. I will also go ahead and stamp many times the cloud. And I'm going to stamp three times the waves. So again, I'm going to use my triblends and color all the images that I have here. Really quick coloring, no need for spending too much time blending. And again, I'm going to use my scissors to fuzzy cut everything. And here I am where I have all the elements already colored and cut out, and I'm going to do some stamping on the background. I will use again the same text stamp, and I'm stamping with black archival ink. I'm not going to switch into different colors that are close to the color of the background, which is a technique that I normally do. Since I'm working on so many pages, I didn't want to have too many products out. And again, I will use the same stencil that I used for the first page. I am applying white paint spray on top. This is going to dry permanent. And I wanted to spray just a touch here and there to tone down the blue at the background. I'm also going to add some splashes. I'm going to leave those to dry and then I will start putting everything together. Here I'm using my white glue and I'm going to stick the waves down all the way to the bottom. I stamped and cut out the waves three times, so I have plenty of pieces, and the third one I did cut it out into smaller pieces so that I can tuck them behind the first row of waves. Now I'm going to stick on top the rest of the cutouts. For the balloon, there were many details that I didn't want to take the time to cut out. That's why I am going to stamp that so that I can have the details all around the balloon. This way I do have the strings, for example, connecting the balloon with the fish, and now I can stick all the cutouts on top. For sticking all my elements, I like to go with my white glue because once I place an element on top of my page, I can only slide it until I'm happy with the placement. You can of course go with a glue stick, you can use your double-sided tape, you can use your tape runner, or even your matte medium, anything goes. Now here is where I want my little boat to be. I'm going to stamp only the top part of the boat, since there are areas that I didn't bother to cut out again. This way I have all the detail on my background and I can stick only the sails on top. I also have a little flag that I colored red. You can even use that flag to personalize your page and color it in the colors of your country if you like. It would be a fun touch. I did place down the three clouds and I'm also using my white gel pen to add some details, again highlighting my cutouts. And at this stage, I thought that the waves at the bottom didn't look as part of the whole design. That's why I'm going to do some stamping, which is the stamping that I have on the background as well. So it is a little detail that brings things together. I'm also going to cut out a part of this stamp. It's not screaming, don't worry about that. I just wanted to have the bubbles underneath. Of course, you can mask it if you don't want to cut out parts of your stamp. There's no need to do that if you don't want to. I'm going to stamp the bubbles coming out of the clouds, and I'm rotating the stamp so that they don't all look identical. I'm going to fill them in with my white gel pen. And I absolutely love how this page came together. It looks so surreal with all the clouds and the bubbles on the sky, as well as the fish with the balloon. Art by Marlene Designs helps you do that effortlessly. Now, in my world, art journal pages need a quote. So for one of them, I'm going to use the sticker that says Dream Big. And on the other side of the layout, I will use the Create Your Own Whimsical World, which I think they both combine beautifully together. Again, I'm going to bring in my white gel pen as well as my fine black marker, and I will go around the quote. Notice that I'm always using colors that they are contrasting with the background, so even though it looks quite busy, you can always tell which are the focal points. Even for the waves, which are blue on blue, I did use different shades of blue from the background, and I also made sure that the top line was white so that it separates it from the background. One of my favorite collage papers from both the collage booklets is this one, which I'm going to use for this double spread. I'm going to again cut it to size and stick it down with my matte medium, just like I did for the first page. And once everything was dry, I did go ahead and did some stamping, again using black archival ink and that text stamp that I have been using throughout the whole booklet. Again, I'm going to bring in the same stencil and I will go over it in a couple of areas with my spray paint. And always make sure that this is completely dry before you move on to the next step. Now, one of the tabs isn't covered with that tissue paper, that's why I want to cover it up somehow with one of the die cuts. In the die cut booklets, you always get twice the same design, and I did use them both here. And for this page, I'm going with the Happy Holiday stamp set. It gives you lots and lots of designs to play with. There is even a lighthouse, which is quite big, perfect for a tag. There is also a bus that has a brush on top, really fun, a little house. For my page, however, I'm going to use just two of the designs. I will color all the images again using my tree blends, using really colorful markers to keep everything nice and bright and super happy. And I'm not going for a realistic look here. You can see my mountains are all kinds of crazy. I did fuzzy cut everything, and now I'm going to stamp the sun on a scrap piece of that collage paper so that I can cut it out. And for putting everything together, I did combine the fuzzy cut images that I colored. I also combined pieces of that washi tape that I used for the first page as well, and also die cuts from the booklets. I'm going for a super colorful and crazy layout here, where you can see that the mounds are kind of floating there, keeping that whimsical and super colorful theme that I have throughout the pages. Now, I did pop out a bulb from the booklet, which I'm going to use at the top of my caravan there. I'm just adding some fun touches here and there to make my page even more fun. Now, at the top of those mountains, the stamp had flags, which I didn't bother to cut out, obviously. So I'm just going to stick other elements that I popped out from the booklet, like a cherry on top of one of the mountains. There is a leaf for the yellow one, as well as a heart for the green one. And of course, you can never stop. You can just keep on popping out images from the booklets and sticking them here and there. I am going to stick that those arrows just because they are white and I love the contrast that they give on the top of that page. And I just keep on going. I'm going to stamp the a sun on top, making sure that I stamp a part of it on top of my arrows. This way it becomes part of the whole composition. I'm going to stick the cutout sun at the center. And for this layout, I combined two quotes, one that says every day is a new opportunity, as well as artistic adventures. And this booklet that I have from a previous collection, full of quotes, has all the quotes in both white background as well as black background. And I combined both of them for the artistic adventures phrase. And you can see here some close-up photos where you can see in detail all the different elements. I absolutely love this layout just because it's super crazy. And at this moment I realized that the video is already 20 minutes long, so I'm happy that I used only 3 tags to create my little tag journal. And I only have to walk you through the last page, which is just a single page, the back cover of the booklet. Here is the Sunny Days stamp set. You see that there are big, lovely elements that you can use as focal points, including that hot air balloon. However, for my page today, I will go just with the cloud and the rainbow. For the background, I'm going to choose one of the collage papers and stick it down, just like I did with all of the rest of the pages. Here is a favorite. It's the hot air balloon that I'm keeping for another layout. So again, I'm doing my stamping, and on the rainbow you will see that there are lovely details on the edges, which I'm not going to use for this layout, so I will chop off the star and the moon. But also notice that this rainbow doesn't have all the colors, it only includes 4 of them, so I stopped at green. But again, just keep in mind that this is your own art journal. You can use any colors that you wish on your rainbow. You can even go with shades of pink for all the rows if you want to. And again, same techniques. I'm doing my stamping. I have a piece of collage paper here, and I also popped out that frame that I have on my right, which you will find in one of the die-cut booklets. I'm also doing some stamping on my background, mainly staying on the edges this time. And now for my composition, I'm going to use glue at the back of my frame. I'm just rotating it, trying to decide which way I want that to go on my page. And I'm going to stick it on top of that collage paper. And I want my rainbow to look as if it is coming from behind that frame all the way out. And I'm moving quickly before the glue dries. And then I'm going to place this frame with a rainbow on top of my page, but I'm not going to center it on the page. I like to have it on the side. I think it looks more interesting this way, as if there is something going on outside of the page. So I'm going to place it down, secure it with my glue. I'm also going to add the cloud on the other side of the rainbow, and I will use my scissors to cut off the excess paper. Now I am going through my booklet of die cuts, and this is where I found the frame that I used. And I'm going for a little heart that I can pop out and use on top of my cloud. There is already one drawn there, but I wanted it to be more prominent, more bigger. And the cloud stamp has little hearts coming out from the cloud, so I'm going to stamp those underneath my cloud. And this way I will be able to color them in with my white gel pen. This is a great opportunity for you to use gems if you like, falling from the cloud. I will also use the gel pen now that I have that on hand to add my highlights. And here I was debating if I want to create a cluster of flowers and leaves in one corner of the frame, but then I thought that it looks just fine as it is. It has lovely colors and lots of details on the background and on the foreground, so I decided to leave it as it is. And for the quote on this page, I went with "Be a rainbow in someone's cloud," which I think is perfect and so appropriate for this page. And again, I'm going to finish it off with some doodling around the quote. You will find close-up photos on this page at the end of this video, but let's take a quick look on the whole tag journal now that it is finished. I have to say that I always have lots and lots of fun when I am creating tag journals, and I also hope that you have fun watching as well as get inspired. Don't forget, you will find the full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area as well as on my blog. Here are some close-up photos. Don't forget to leave me a comment and to like the video. Thank you all so much for visiting today, and I'll see you all next time.